Consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
And good morning to you all, those of you who are here with us at this gathering here at San Fernando Cemetery. All of those of you who are at home watching this live stream. And let's now call to mind our sinfulness as we turn to our Father in Heaven, to ask him for his forgiveness so we can be worthy to be in his presence and celebrate this Eucharist. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your departed servants that with the mortality of life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, their Creator and Redeemer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The just person, though dying early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Understanding is gray hair, and a spotless life is a ripe old age. The one who pleased God was loved. The one who lived among sinners was transported, snatched away, lest wickedness pervert the mind or deceit beguile the soul. For the fascination of evil obscures true values, and restless desire undermines a simple heart. Having become perfect in a short while, the just one reached the fullness of a long career. This one's soul was pleasing to the Lord, and therefore was quickly removed from the midst of wickedness. People saw but did not understand, and it did not occur to them that God's grace and mercy are with God's chosen ones, and God's care is with the holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. El Señor es mi pastor. Shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. El Señor es mi pastor. Nada me falta. En verdes praderas me hace recostar. Me conduce hacia fuentes tranquilas y reparas mis fuerzas. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta, the Lord is my shepherd. Nothing I shall want. Me guía por el sendero justo, por el honor de su nombre, aunque camine por cañadas oscuras. Daré temo porque tú vas conmigo, tu vara y tu callado me sosiega. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta, the Lord is my shepherd. Nothing I shall want. Preparas una mesa ante mí, en frente de mis enemigos. Me unges la cabeza con perfume. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Tu bondad y tu misericordia me acompañan todos los días de mi vida, y habitaré en la casa del Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Juan. Queridos hijos, miren cuánto amor nos ha tenido el Padre, pues no solo nos llamamos hijos de Dios, sino que lo somos. Si el mundo no nos reconoce, es porque tampoco lo han reconocido a Él. Hermanos míos, ahora somos hijos de Dios, pero aún no se ha manifestado cómo seremos al fin. Y ya sabemos que cuando Él se manifieste, lo veremos tal cual es, porque seremos semejantes a Él. Palabra de Dios.
Vamos, Señor.
Jesús resucitó, canta que queremos en su honor, porque a la muerte derrotó. Aleluya, 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 aleluya.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her and said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin. At this, the bearers halted, and he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." This report about him spread through the whole of Judea and in all the surrounding region. En aquel tiempo se dirigía Jesús a una población llamada Nain, acompañado de sus discípulos y de mucha gente. Al llegar a la entrada de la población, se encontró con que se acaban a enterrar a un muerto, hijo único de una viuda a la que acompañaba una gran muchedumbre. Cuando el Señor la vio, se compadeció de ella y le dijo, "No llores." Acercándose al ataúd, lo tocó y los que yo llevaban se detuvieron. Entonces Jesús dijo, "Joven, yo te mando, levántate." Inmediatamente el que había muerto se levantó y comenzó a hablar. Jesús se lo entregó a su madre. Al ver esto, todos se llenaron de temor y comenzaron a glorificar a Dios, diciendo, un gran profeta ha surgido entre nosotros. Dios ha visitado a su pueblo. La noticia de este hecho se divulgó por toda Judea y por las regiones circunvecinas. Palabra del Señor.
Gloria a ti, Señor Jesús.
A pleasant morning to all of you, and it's wonderful to be able to celebrate Mass like this again. And of course, as we all know, our parishes have opened up, has been open for the past couple of weeks now, and people are slowly coming back to church and really are very, very moved by the experience of being able to worship again as a community in our churches. This is a beautiful gospel that we heard today, the raising by Jesus of a young man, the only son of a mother who had passed on. And what that really meant to the mother was a big question mark as to how she was going to continue to provide for herself. Because as we know, during the time of Jesus, the responsibility of providing for the family rests, of course, on the father. But when the father is no longer there, as in this particular case, the son was the one who was supposed to do it. In this particular story, we are told that this man who had died was an only son. And so you can just imagine how the mother must be feeling with no one to take care of her anymore and no one to earn a living for herself so that she can provide for herself. It must have been a really, really devastating blow to the mother. But then comes Jesus, and Jesus, out of compassion and pity for the mother, raises this man from the dead. And this is one of a few stories in the gospel where we are told of Jesus actually raising someone from the dead. And in this particular case, you know, the man had not been dead for a very long time yet. Lazarus was a different story. Lazarus was already dead for a number of days when Jesus arrived. But in this particular case, Jesus raises this man as he was being processed from wherever it was to the place of burial. And the man, of course, is resuscitated. He lives again. And what joy it must have been to all of those who experienced that particular event, especially the mother who thought that she was now by herself in the world, just wondering how she was going to provide for herself. But you can just imagine what joy that must have been to all the people there who witnessed this particular event, and also the mother who was there to thank Jesus, I'm sure, for what it is that he has done for her. That particular story, you know, is such a stark contrast to many of the deaths that we are seeing happening in our midst right now because of the pandemic, because of COVID-19. I'm sure you and I, you are as aware as I am that people who have this illness, who are sick of COVID-19, are not allowed visitors in the hospital, and many times, and I understand in our midst, it's almost all the time, someone passes on succumbing to the disease without anyone there, without any of their loved ones or family or someone that they knew during their life being present to them. Thank God, you know, the hospital workers and nurses are doing a wonderful job making sure that the person feels that there is someone there next to them as they breathe their last. But of course, you know, most of them are conscious of that fact already, because as they struggle to breathe their last, they are by themselves. There's no one really there that they know who would be next to them. That is really such a tragedy, and of course, it makes us wonder, you know, what is happening? Why is God allowing this? And when are we going to be able to again support and be present to those people who are dying, so that they can feel the love of the people whom they have been with throughout their lives, especially the God of ours, who in the particular story that we just heard in the gospel really reached out to someone who was in deep grief, giving her comfort, as a matter of fact, giving her son back to her. Thank God that now we are able to go back to church. We are able to worship again in church, and so many people are just in tears, I understand. I have spoken with a few pastors with regard to their experience this past 2 weeks at Masses that they have celebrated, and they said that at almost every Mass, there was someone who would come up to them to receive Holy Communion in tears, just so thankful that they are once again able to feel the presence of God in their lives, and to know that God really is with us and is going to help us get through this. But like I said, there are many people who at this point in time still are wondering, still are questioning, where is God in all this? We see some light, we see some hope, we see things going back to normal, but like I said, there are still many people who are wondering, where is God in all this? All I can say at this time is that we need to continue to keep the faith and continue to pray that we get through this, and still continue to express our faith and hope and love to our God, who we know is very much still around us. During those moments when we have very deep doubts as to where our Lord is at this time, it would really be good for us to remember this particular gospel story. We don't know exactly how God is present to us at this time, but we do know that He is very much present. For me, just the very fact that now we are able to worship again, just like we did in our churches, celebrating liturgies, and once again receiving Holy Communion, is a great, great sign to me that God really is very much present, that God has not left. But we are subject, of course, to things that happen to us in nature, that is something that we really cannot change. But in the midst of that, in the midst of the sadness that we feel, because I don't know about you, but I know people who have passed because of COVID-19, and so there's deep sadness, of course, in the family of this friend. One particular friend comes to mind right now, but we continue to put our faith and hope in God. This is something temporary, and we know that things are going to pass. What we need to do is pray to the Lord to help us learn the lessons from this experience. And that's like I was telling you, this friend of mine, he developed COVID-19, and his family took him to the hospital. And as soon as he arrived at the emergency room, the personnel of the emergency room told his family that they could not enter, that he was the only one who was allowed there. And they did not see him again until after he died. And his wife was called to the hospital to identify his body. what a sad way to see your loved one go. You know, but I was talking to this family, and they, despite what happened to them, they are still filled with hope and trust in the Lord. Thankfully, he was the only one in the family who was afflicted with a disease. But this is a family of faith. This is a family who every Sunday went to church with their loved one. And now this the head of the family was returned to them, you know, in an urn after he was cremated, and that's the memory that they have of this loved one in their home at the moment, because they're not even able to have a burial yet, because they would like the family to be present at the burial, and they're not able to be together at the burial. But what sadness it must be for this family who is experiencing this at the moment. But like I said, I am inspired by this family, because despite what happened to them, they are filled with faith. They know that things are going to get better. And they consider the fact that no one else in the family was afflicted by this by the disease as a blessing of God to them. Hard for some to really appreciate, but this family is just so thankful. And I said, I am inspired by their faith in the Lord, because the Lord is going to get us through this. We are already seeing some light at the end of the tunnel. Sometimes we see in the news reports that the cases are going up, but I don't know what your experience with regard to that is concerned, but what gives me a lot of joy and hope in my heart is the joy and hope that I see in people who come to church on the Sundays since we have opened. And I know that if we keep this hope, we will continue to be joyful, because things are going to return to normal. It may take a little bit of time, but we just need to trust in the Lord and do everything we can to make sure that we and our loved ones are safe. Brothers and sisters, we pray today in a special way for all the dearly beloved that have died and were unable to have regular funeral services because of the quarantine due to the coronavirus pandemic. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to His.
In baptism, we all received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead our loved ones over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Nuestros hermanos fueron alimentados en la mesa del Salvador. Acógelos en las mansiones del banquete celestial. Rogamos al Señor.
Te rogamos, Señor.
For the many people suffering from the coronavirus, for their families, and for all those working to care for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Las familias y los amigos de los que han ido a Dios buscan paz y consuelo. Alivia su pena y disipa la oscuridad y la duda que nacen de la aflicción. Rogamos al Señor.
Te rogamos, Señor.
Let us now pray for the faithful departed who have been laid to rest during this time of quarantine. We offer our prayers to God for each of them as their name is now being called.
The following individuals have entered eternal life and were recently served by our Catholic cemeteries and mortuaries. All Souls Cemetery and Mortuary, Long Beach.
Giuseppe Boconfuso.
Socorro Boniface.
Jose Borges Avila.
Arnulfo Caudelario.
Alice Del Carmen.
Juanita Guerrero.
Maria Gonzalez.
Elena Hudakova.
Hiep Lee.
Jesus Ortega Macias.
Mario Saenz.
Carmen Sanchez.
Madeline Smith.
Charlene Snyder.
John Van Ruten.
Sasha Veloso Rodriguez.
Ronnie Williams.
Joseph Zine.
Assumption Cemetery, Simi Valley.
Eleanor Martha Babb.
Ronald Perez.
Mateo Ray Silva.
Maria Zaragoza.
Calvary Cemetery and Mortuary, Los Angeles.
Carmen Mata Alva.
Consuelo Baldwin.
Maria Chavez.
Vivian Crute.
Helen N. Garcia.
Esther Corona Gonzalez.
Modesta Lara Lopez.
Mitsuko Matsumoto.
Sylvia Ortiz.
Concha Perez.
Ruben Hector Ramirez.
Hector Ruben Ramirez.
Ana Rodriguez.
Antonia S. Rodriguez.
Manuel Rosales.
Phyllis Mary Strawling.
Calvary Cemetery, Santa Barbara.
Francisco Cervantes.
Emily Fajardo.
Good Shepherd Cemetery, Lancaster.
Maria Mejia.
Leslie Nelson.
Sonia Palacio.
Ronald Stegeman.
Holy Cross Cemetery and Mortuary, Culver City.
Irene Atencio.
Robert Athan Castillo.
Henry Guzman.
Therese Holtz.
Kathleen Marie Kenyon.
Christine Marquez.
Monica Ann McClellan.
Karen McGovern.
Ernest Wellington Megan Jr.
Alberto Montez.
Rosamilia Neverida.
Maria Niebla.
John Plutnik.
Cirilla D. Rivero Rivero.
Timothy Sanford Robinson.
Audrey Severin.
April Stone.
Eunice Lillian Taylor.
Raphael Victorine.
Ruby Wooten.
Gloria Ann Younger.
Holy Cross Cemetery, Pomona.
Grace Alvarado.
Alberto Garcia.
Brenda Lerma.
Victor Palacios.
Queen of Heaven Cemetery and Mortuary, Roland Heights.
Mary Abu Jaber.
Jean Ombres.
Irma Yolanda Campista de Rodriguez.
Hui Chen Chin.
Chung H. Chu.
Shala de Guzman.
Conrada Pita de Priego.
Virginia Diaz.
Rachel Duran.
Rosa Estrella.
Lori Flores.
Jose Tirado Garcia.
James Hopper.
Mary Ellen Krolick.
Pamela Jane Lopez.
Barney Martinez.
Isagani Militante.
Selena Alexa Quintero Pena.
Oscar Armando Reyes.
Andrew Rios.
Ricardo Zepeda.
Jose Zuniga.
Resurrection Cemetery, Rosemead.
Domingo Aguilar.
Jesus Banuelos.
Isabel Banuelos.
Marlene Barnes.
Margarita Beas.
Rosa Chavez.
Josefina De Vera.
Crispina Delgadillo.
Sarah Dominguez.
Mary Escalante.
Salvador Escamilla.
Destiny Felix.
Robert Fernandez.
Caroline Flores.
Andrea Gomez.
Catherine Gray.
Rosemary Hayward.
Magdalena Lara.
Martin Macias.
Juan Morales.
Fidel Murillo.
Blanca Pena.
Efren Perez.
Robert Puente.
Ruben Rodriguez.
Francisca Sanchez.
Manuel Signon.
Thelma Velasquez.
Oi Hua Chow Young.
Oswaldo Zepeda.
San Fernando Mission Cemetery and Mission Hills Catholic Mortuary, Mission Hills.
Marie Abernethy.
Herbert Altamirano.
Philip Hannah Ayad.
Soledad Barrera.
Maria Barreto.
Isauro Birueta.
Romeo Busuego.
Balvina Casares.
Ellen Q.
Miriam De Jesus Quevedo.
Liberty De La Fuente.
Nelson Dean English.
Patricia Gartland.
Gloria Hernandez.
Mercedes Leal.
Celita Lopez.
Jesus Lopez.
Madeline A. Martin Swindon.
Maura Orozco.
Annabelle Peterson.
Gloria Prony.
Monico Ramirez.
Kathleen Regan.
Rose Rosier.
Ramon Rubalcava.
John J. Taglieri.
Felix Tapia.
Jennifer Williams.
Santa Clara Cemetery and Mortuary, Oxnard.
Angelina Alonso.
Hector Castellanos Lucatero.
Daniel Chaparro.
Jose Luis Esparza.
Keith Allen Henry.
Rosa Lopez.
Cesar Mazariegos.
Delfina Palazuelos.
Amalia Ramirez de Escobedo.
Julia Reyes.
And we offer this flower for all healthcare professionals, doctors, nurses, respiratory therapists, and all hospital workers who care for COVID patients and also for emergency medical technicians. Señor Dios, que nos das la paz y sanas nuestras almas, escucha las voces de tus fieles, cuyas vidas fueron redimidas por la sangre del Cordero. perdona los pecados de todos los que duermen en Cristo y concédeles un lugar en tu reino, el que vive y reina por los siglos de los siglos. Amén.
Hazme un instrumento de tu paz, donde haya odio lleve yo tu amor, donde haya un muria tu perdón, Señor, donde haya duda fe.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, on these sacrificial offerings we present to you for the souls of your servants. And just as you bestowed on them the dignity of the Christian faith, grant them also its reward through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone, he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man, he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Santo, 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 santo es el Señor, Dios del universo, llenos están el cielo y la tierra de tu gloria. Hosanna en el cielo, hosanna en el cielo. Bendito el que viene en el nombre del Señor, hosanna en el cielo. Hosanna in the cielo.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Anunciamos tu muerte, proclamamos tu resurrección. Ven, Señor Jesús. Ven, Señor Jesús.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, his auxiliary bishops, all priests and deacons. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but rather look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace with you.
Thank you.
pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros, ten piedad. Cordero de Dios, que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros, ten piedad. El pecado del mundo, danos la paz, danos la.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let's now say the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will sing. I who made the stars of night, I will make their dark bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. Speak my word to them,
shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go.
Let us pray. Habiendo recibido los dones de ese santo sacrificio, te pedimos, Señor, que derrames con abundancia tu misericordia sobre tus siervos difuntos y a quienes diste la gracia del bautismo. Concédeles la plenitud de los gozos eternos por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
And let us continue to keep in our prayers all those who have died without their loved ones around them, especially victims of COVID-19. Let's ask our good Lord to send his holy angels to take them all to their place in heaven. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Resucitó, aleluya, 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 resucitó, la muerte, ¿dónde está la muerte? Su victoria resucitó, 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 aleluya, 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 resucitó. Serán darás al Padre que nos pasó a su reino donde se vivía de hermoso. Resucitó, 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 resucitó.